Hi, future Panthers. We are so excited to be welcoming you to Glasgow next year. Although we weren't able to do our usual visits to your school, we wanted to create a video to give you a feel of what middle school will be like next year. We have included video from previous years as well as this year, so that is the reason why you may see students without masks as well as students with masks on. We wanted to make sure we gave you a preview of both. We hope you enjoy the video.
Ellen Glasgow is, I don't know.
Who is Ellen Glasgow?
I think she's a poet or a writer of some sort. I don't know.
Bienvenue au Collège Glasgow.
Assalamu alaikum.
Thân chào các em học sinh. Hân hạnh mừng đón các em đến Glasgow.
This is the front entrance to our school, or you may hear some call it door number one. As soon as you enter, you will see the main office to your left. As soon as you come in to the office, you will see all of our helpful front office staff. You can always come to the main office if you have questions about the bus, attendance, or if you need any help. This is also where you will be picked up from if you are going home early. If you continue on, you will see a hallway and you will know that you are entering the admin suite. Here's where you will find the offices of our principal and our assistant principals, or as we call them at Glasgow, administrators. Depending on your last name, you will be assigned an administrator and this will be your admin for the school year. You will see your administrators walking in the hallways or even during transitions. So feel free to stop and say hello, as they are here to help and answer any questions that you may have. Oh my goodness, we are so happy you asked. As soon as you leave the admin suite, you will see the counselor suite. This is where majority of the counselor offices are housed. We currently have a total of 9 counselors. Just like your admin, you are assigned a counselor by the first letter of your last name. Your counselor and administrator work together to support you. You can always come and chat with us about things going on at school, home, with friends, and anything else that may come up. As always, remember, when you are with a counselor, you are not in trouble. We are here to help. Once you leave the counselor suite, you will see a long hallway that leads to the gym. In this hallway, you will find the lecture hall, which you can see here. And sometimes it is used as another classroom space. If you continue down the same hallway for a couple more steps, you will see the nurse's office on your left. This is where you will go if you are not feeling well, need a Band-Aid, or have a possible health-related question. And here is the nurse's office. If you turn to your right, you will see another hallway which houses our art classes as well as our technology courses. As you continue down the hallway, you will finally hit the middle of the school. If you look to your left, you will see our awesome library where you can check out books. And if you look to the right, you will see our main stairway. Here you see a sample schedule of a current sixth grade student at Glasgow. As you can see, there's a lot of information shown. Currently, we have 9 periods. Every student who is a student here at Glasgow, and in the county has to take PE, math, science, English, and social studies. And depending on your schedule, you will get 1 to 2 electives, but that isn't always guaranteed. We do have some students who sometimes need some additional support, and if this is the case, your elective will be replaced with an intervention class. Your schedule will show the period, course, teacher, and room number. You will also see an additional 2 periods, which are periods 4 and 9. Period 4 represents Panther time, which is often considered your homeroom. Period 9 is called FIT, and this class is sometimes an enrichment class or, if needed, an intervention support class. You will not have all of your classes every day. Here at Glasgow, we have an even and odd day schedule. So essentially, you will have periods 1, 3, 5, and 7 on odd days, and periods 2, 4, 6, 8 on even days. This is the schedule for right now, and should anything change for next year, do not worry, we are here to help and support with that. You should be receiving your final schedule towards the middle of August via the mail, or you can check it in Student View just in time for school to start.
I have been playing the viola since 4th grade at Bailey's, and I'm also part of the Panther Groove Band, where we get to play our instruments outside of school and in school, such as at the Hoop It Up night basketball game. Today during Spanish class, we played a game where our teacher described a word and we had to write it up on the board in Spanish. Whoever wrote the word fastest got a Jolly Rancher.
Oliver.
To give an injection. Un verbo.
Inyección. Inyección. Igriega. Igriega, Sam. Igriega.
This is FIT Chorus, and right now we're practicing singing Counting Stars a cappella, which means that there's no soundtrack or musical instruments. My favorite part of chorus is in the spring we get to go on the spring trip, which is a competition that is usually hosted at an amusement park, so that's always really fun.
Thank you.
Okay, Nardos, what was hardest about transitioning to Glasgow from your elementary school?
The most hardest thing was that you have different classes and like different teachers, so you always have to transition between the classes.
What do you like most about middle school?
I like that we have electives, so we get to choose our own classes and we pick what we learn.
How many times did you get lost at the beginning of the year?
I got lost about 6 or 7 times.
How much time do you have between classes, and are you ever late?
We get about 5 minutes between the classes, and there's a warning bell, so usually after the warning bell rings, I'm probably in class. I use my agenda to keep track of what homeworks I have, and I also sometimes use it to jot down, like, if we have tests and if I need to study for them. And if I don't have homework, I just write no homework for each class.
How many times did you get lost at the beginning of the year?
I got lost a lot depending on which class it was, because some of them are far away, some of them are really close, and I don't even notice. Mm-hmm. And so I just get lost and I get late too.
How much time do you have between classes, and are you ever late?
Well, we have 5 minutes to transition to our next class, and I am late sometimes because I forget where the class is and I just get late.
What's the hardest part about transitioning to Glasgow from your elementary school?
Well, the hardest thing from transitioning from elementary school to middle school was not having recess, because you don't get like to hang out with your friends outside, so that was the hardest thing for me.
What do you like most about middle school?
What I like the most about middle school is that you learn more and you're getting ready for the outside world more.
My point of confusion is, what is the equation to find the volume of a rectangular prism?
What I like about Avid is tutorials, because you can present a question and they help you get the answer, but they don't just tell you the answer. They ask you questions to help you reach the answer. So that's what I like most about Avid. And some field trips we've been on were to Jeb Stuart High School. We got to tour and to see what programs they're available. And we also went to Marymount to like see the college and see what it's like to be on a campus. And the laptop and the MiFi, they give you a form to sign to take it home or leave it in school. That's to help you if you don't have a laptop at home to do your homework or any research you have to do, but you have to be very responsible. The ambassador program is something the teachers ask you to volunteer if you want to help new students and tour them around the school and help them like know the school. Just like at the beginning of the year, people are going to help you.
Here at Glasgow, we have four lunch periods: A lunch, B lunch, C lunch, and D lunch. Each lunch is assigned according to where your fifth period on odd days or sixth period on even day classes are located. During lunch, students can listen to music via headphones and use their cell phones, but you may not make videos or make phone calls. Usually for the first 2 weeks, students can sit anywhere and eventually need to pick their permanent seat for the year. As of right now, due to COVID, desks are used to make sure that all students are socially distancing correctly. Teachers, counselors, and administrators are present for every lunch period and help distribute lunches and answer any questions you may have. The following video shows what lunch was like before social distancing.
Some of my favorite foods to get in the cafeteria are pizza and spicy chicken. And some of the foods I don't like would include peanut butter and jelly sandwich and probably most of the salads. A lot of kids like to get Cheetos or Doritos from the vending machine a lot.
This is a question that we get often. While we do have lockers available, they are only given via student request. We are too big of a school to assign every single student a locker. Usually around the middle of September, we will make an announcement via the morning announcements regarding lockers. Once the announcement is made, students can come to Student Services and request a locker form. You will then go home and have a parent sign the form and bring it back. Also note that once we give you the form, we will not be following up with you, so it is your responsibility to bring the form back. Once we get it back, you will be assigned a locker. And you are able to access this locker before your first class, as well as at dismissal every day. At the end of the day, all students are released and you are able to go home. Students ride the bus, walk home, or have a parent or guardian pick them up. If you are a bus rider, you simply go out door number 3 and head out to the buses. Here is a look at our bus loop board that we have outside of the buses, and this lets you know where your bus is located. If you can't find your bus or you need any help, all the administrators and there are other staff members outside ready to help and make sure that you get on the right bus. We are so excited to welcome you all to sixth grade next year. We know that some of you may be feeling nervous or scared, and we want you to know that that is okay. Every new sixth grader or even just new students to Glasgow feel like that, and it just takes some time to get used to middle school. We are all here to help and can't wait to meet you all. See you next year, Future Panthers. Love, your counselors in Student Services.